India, and we are here for the third partnership summit. Just to give you a little bit of context of the new state of Andhra Pradesh, we are a bifurcated smaller state. When the state got bifurcated in 2014, we were a capitalless state. Just to give you a few data points, we actually have the lowest per capita income in South India, and lowest by almost 25%. But under the leadership of our the visionary Chief Minister, Shri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu, we have three clear deliverables or targets as state ministers. The first one, by 2022, to be among the top three states in India in terms of per capita income. By 2029, to be the number one state, not only in terms of per capita income, but also happiness. And you won't believe that is literally the only portfolio that our Honorable Chief Minister today holds, which is happiness. And by 2050, actually compete with countries in South and Southeast Asia. In order to do this, we as a state have to grow at 15%. 15% year on year. Today, being the fastest growing state in India, we are able to deliver 11.61%. That is almost double of India's growth, but nowhere close to our Honorable Chief Minister's satisfaction. Our Honorable Chief Minister, as I say, is a legendary serial entrepreneur. In his first venture, he started a city called Cyberabad. And Cyberabad today, as you all know, is known for services sector. It was one man with his vision, he's been able to transform what otherwise was a sleepy city of Hyderabad into today a services capital of South India. He's now embarking on Andhra Pradesh 2.0, a new state, except challenges are aplenty. As a state today, we have opportunity to build brownfield cities, and post-independence, India is actually taking its first shot at building a greenfield capital city called Amravati. You know, it's really exciting journey for us in Andhra Pradesh. Today, we are looking at cluster-based development, a more decentralized development. If you look at where we are today in Visakhapatnam, Visakhapatnam is not only the IT capital of Andhra Pradesh, it is now the fintech capital of India. Apart from that, pharma has made great strides here in Visakhapatnam. We now have a medical devices manufacturing zone coming up rapidly. Going southward, Amravati, as I already said, is a greenfield capital city. It took us 3 years to pool close to 35,000 acres from the farmers of Andhra Pradesh. The entire master plan has been developed with the help of Singaporeans. We're using Norman Foster of London to develop marquee buildings. We're using the Dutch to actually create the entire blue zone. So what you're going to see in making is truly a world-class city. And our Honorable Chief Minister already alluded to the fact that it is going to be among the top five most livable cities on this planet. Amravati is shaping up to be actually a high-tech capital. A lot of intellectual property-based development, chip designing is happening now in Amravati. We've recently closed with HCL, which is among the top five IT companies in India, to actually start working on the IP that they've acquired from the biggies like IBM. Apart from that, going southward more, the Rayalaseema cluster. Rayalaseema historically has been a backward part of Andhra Pradesh, not anymore. The four districts of Rayalaseema have seen amazing growth in manufacturing. You know, Kia, I think, is a marquee example of that. From the date of signing the MOU to the first car rolling out, it's taking us less than 15 months. It's not 50, it is 15. This shows the speed at which government of Andhra Pradesh is now moving. We are lucky to have Foxconn in Rayalaseema. PepsiCo is already there, Isuzu is there. Like that, and various companies have now already started their operations and many more are underway. We are a three-year-old state. We are the youngest state in India. But we are number one in ease of doing business. And I'm sure under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, we will continue to be number one. It's very important that we not only get the rankings, but actually walk the talk. You know, for all the businessmen who are sitting here, You know, there are a few more most important things that you look forward to. First thing is land, power, water, and skilled manpower. Andhra Pradesh today has the highest land bank in the country. Litigation-free land bank. So from the day you apply, in 21 days flat, we can actually alienate land to you. And the Honorable Chief Minister already spoke about power. We are the first state in the country to actually announce we are not going to increase power prices. In fact, we are a state that added 4.6 gigawatts of renewable energy in the last 3 years. 4.6 gigawatts. Andhra Pradesh is the home to the world's single largest, single location and the single largest solar installation, 1 gigawatt, which is now in Rayalaseema. Apart from that, under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, we are the first state to interlink two rivers. India since independence has been talking about this, interlinking rivers. But under his able leadership, in 9 months flat, we've been able to link the two important rivers of Andhra Pradesh, which is Godavari and Krishna. Through this, we are able to take water not only to these districts, but also to the backward districts of the state, whereby it will enable all of you to start your businesses in Andhra Pradesh. Skilled workforce is very, very important, and we in government are very good at spending money. So we are looking at industry, we are looking at you to tell us the kind of skilled workforce you need. We want to skill them up. We want to skill up. We want to prepare them for Industry 4.0 and give you work-ready workforce. You know, they will be ready. From the day you turn your machines on, they will be ready to give you the maximum amount of productivity. So unlike other states in India, we actually walk the talk. We have shown that. If you look at permissions across board, we've been able to close aggressively. You know, I must share a few things. You know, it's very difficult to work for our Honorable Chief Minister. We are the only state where the entire secretariat and the entire workforce down has e-office. There are no paper files that come to us as ministers. On a fortnightly basis, he actually reviews us on how much time we are taking to clear files. And believe me, no other state in India is actually doing this. Not only that, all the MOUs that we have entered, like for example in IT department, all the MOUs that we have entered are monitored on a fortnightly basis by the Honorable Chief Minister. Any roadblocks are removed on a war footing basis. You know, as IT Minister, I can only add one thing. It's not about just ease of doing business. It's not just about starting business, but it's also ensuring that your business thrives in Andhra Pradesh. And we, the entire ministers here, will ensure that we will walk the talk. And to the end, I would like to add, welcome to Visakhapatnam. It is the most beautiful city in India. As many have said, we have an amazing beach on one side. We have amazing hills. We have an amazing hill station called Araku. I would urge all of you to visit, take time out of your busy schedule and actually visit this place. Check out what Visakhapatnam has to offer. And once again, welcome to the sunrise state in India, Andhra Pradesh. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.